we are talking about one of my favorite bands of the past 2 weeks, I think, because I go through like phases. Like, there's top five favorite bands, and then there's like every once in a while, every other year, there's like a favorite band or like a favorite artist. So we're talking about Cherry Glazer today. Alright, so the first thing we're talking about are my first impressions of the band. This time when I came across their album, or not the album, their music video for Juicy Socks. That was pretty closely to the beginning. It was just like this girly version of grungy punk rock music, and like the music video was really cool because it was like shot in a party bus, and like the music was kind of, it's not exactly the roughest thing, like it's not, I wouldn't put it head to head with like heavy metal or like core music, hardcore or anything, but it could probably go head to head with like Smashing Pumpkins or even Nirvana, maybe, like pop punkish type vibes. And then the lyrics were really cool because they were like, you know, don't be nervous. But I don't even think I listened to them more after that. I think I was so obsessed with Juicy Socks and like the music video and the song and stuff and just overall that type of vibe. And then like I never really gotten into female rock music. I think like as far as female rock goes, there's like Paramore, but that's honestly so, it turned off a lot of people because it was really like cliche and she was the only female rock artist in the scene at the time. Aside from like a Wrestle to Bear once, that was the only other female led band that I could think of. Maybe Flyleaf was also a female led band. It was like screamo-ish, but like I had never really heard anything, you know, that either it wasn't screamo or because I wasn't exposed, or maybe it wasn't because I just never really looked into it. But I think it to me, my YouTube page or my YouTube recommended, whatever. It was calm. It was nice. It was, you know, that rock vibe. You know, that fuzzy guitar vibes and everything. But it was kind of low key and stuff. And like I don't know. It was just really up my alley with everything that I, you know, was getting into at the time, what I was listening to, and I really liked it. And the lead singer was, oh, it was cool, because like chicks, I honestly feel like girls have it easy with like how they can find artists or movie actors or whatever and like be like, oh, they're super cool and awesome, but they're also like looking, you know. I feel like dudes don't really get that. It's like with rock music or actors or game players, you know, it's like we all have to look up to dudes, and girls get to look up to dudes and also like be attracted to them. Like if you're straight or whatever, or like into chicks or whatever, you don't really get that opportunity. So I don't know, it was kind of cool because I never really had that opportunity to be like, oh my god, this music's so awesome, but like the artist is also good looking, you know. That was just a whole new world for me. So I really appreciated that, so I kind of, you know, gravitated to that in a sense. Alrighty, so the next thing we're talking about are the lyrics. Self-explained. I started reeking of the people I was with. I have no secret, I was freaking out a bit. I took a chopper because I grew up with a lot of changes. I am alone a lot, I see this as my weakness. Now, I don't really usually dissect Cherry Glazer's songs or lyrics or anything. I like to be lighthearted and stuff, and in terms of metaphors or anything, I mean, honestly, if you hang out with anybody a lot, you probably smell like them. But I don't, as far as lyrics go, I don't think she meant that literally, you know? I think she meant that, like, you know, hanging out with people a lot can have an effect on you, you know? You can start becoming other people or losing yourself when you hang out with anyone that is too different from you, or, you know, they have strong personalities. You start hanging out with people with a lot of strong personalities, you honestly find yourself losing yourself into that. So I think that's what I was talking about. And the I have no secret, I was freaking out a bit, you know, is evident of that, you know. You start looking yourself in the mirror and you start reflecting and you're like, nah, that's not who I am, you know? And it's interesting because when you finally come face to face with that stuff, you either you make the decision to leave or you make the decision to kind of, you know, influence your friends instead of, you know? Because you can do that, right? You don't have to just give up on your friends. You can just be like, you know, I'm gonna take charge of things and, you know, put yourself out there, you know? Maybe have them pick up on habits that you do or pick up on your personality, your strong personality traits, and then you won't actually lose yourself in your friends. You find yourself that you're just around people who have a lot of the same interests and things. And which can be really fun. I think that's the whole point of friends, is that y'all just kind of reflect on each other, reflect each other's cool traits and stuff, which is cool. I took a chopper because I grew up with a lot of changes. Everybody can relate to that. I don't think there's anybody, unless you're like super wealthy or super privileged or something, everybody grows up with a lot of changes. I am embarrassed of my solo. I don't know why. I don't want people to know how much time I spend alone. I think a lot of you have that problem where they don't want people to know how much time they spend alone or how much time they aren't actually hanging out or having a good time. The, what is it, FOMO? You know, fear of missing out. You know, it's one thing to have FOMO because everybody relates to it. It's another thing if you don't even have that and you just like being alone, because some people don't relate to that. A lot of people won't admit that they like being alone and stuff. And I don't think, as a society, I don't think that's a healthy thing. I think we need to accept the fact that everybody likes to be alone. Everybody likes, you know, having their own space and stuff, you know. That doesn't take away from the fact that you want to be charitable or, like, you know, you want to be a good person. You just, everybody needs their own space. And the fact that, you know, everybody does get lonely. And I think we can all come together on the fact that we sometimes just like being alone, you know. Sometimes we just like being lonely and dorky and weird and, you know, be a bunch of vampires. A lot of this song has to do with the fact that, yeah, being a lonely person and being, you know, who you are isn't exactly accepted, isn't exactly seen as like a common thing, and I don't think that's cool. I don't think that's right. I think, you know, we should all just kind of be who we are, be who we want to be as lonely as we want to be as affectionate, or even like, what is it when you want people to hang out with you? Like, just be, you know, socially as much as you want to be, because the only thing that's gonna get us through anything is just being who we are and accepting that and pushing through. Because it's one thing to fight with like the world, but it's another thing to fight with yourself. Like, you just have to accept it, you know. I think that was like Clementine's reflection of her own self. I think she was coming to terms with how she felt on the inside when it came to that song. So the next we're talking about are the band similarities. Someone said tantric rock to describe a Cherry Glazer, and I mean, I guess, yeah, I mean, honestly, I think that was a good way to put it. Tantric rock, because fuzzy rock, maybe Sonic Youth, but I don't know, because there's a little more energy to it than Sonic Youth, you know? It's a little more fuzzy. I think nowadays we're blowing past the idea that, you know, people sound like each other. I think there's so many unique artists nowadays that it's hard to be like, oh, they sound like this band, you know? They just kind of, everybody's trying to bring a little bit more to the table, and I think that's honestly really cool, because now, I mean, subgenres, I mean, genres in its own have kind of just kind of, you know, flown away with music in general, I think, because there's way too many subgenres now, you know. It's like, you might as well just combine genres. You got hip-hop rock, and you got rock EDM, and you got EDM rock, and all these things. So, I think I've been doing this a lot where I've been just like, you know, coming to terms that bands nowadays don't sound, you know, you can't really pinpoint exactly who they sound like, because they're just so unique nowadays, and it's really cool. It's really cool to have that. My favorite song off this album, there's other stuff, and there was you know, I think there's at least one song or two songs that I like off of each album from Cherry Blazer. Technically, Juicy Socks is off of Stuffed and Ready, so I kind of want to go with Juicy Socks. Pressure was really good, Isolation was really good, That's Not My Real Life was really good, Daddy was really good. I mean, this whole album was just chock full of good singles that it's really hard to pick, but I'm probably just going to go with Juicy Socks because that's what got me into Cherry Blazer. I guess the door to music that I haven't really listened to. So yeah. Alrighty. So last one we talk about are the singing and screaming styles of Cherry Blazer. Now, I rarely ever hear her screaming like full-on guttural sound, so a pig squeal or anything. It's nothing like that. It's not like a heavy metal or hardcore band. It's like it's a little bit more rough than like indie rock or alternative. As far as hardcore and like screamo goes, it'd probably be on the level of like 21 Pilots or My Chemical Romance. Like, it's rarely ever that it's just screaming. It does have like very rhythmic singing vocals. It does have, you know, a steady singing and like song vocals, and that leads up to a scream, or there's a couple of screams here and there, but it's never like just straight up screaming and straight up this or that. Very rhythmic and melodies. It's very, I don't want to say pop rock because it's not pop. Like, when you think of pop is like popular music, like it's happy, peppy music, hip hop, or all kinds of genres. I mean, it's not that category. But like I said, it's hard to really pinpoint what exactly this genre is, just because it's so unique and it's so like homegrown that it's hard to put it. But it's very melodic and it's very, you know, sustained. And you know, there's a couple screams here and there, but it's not really like just continuous screaming or, you know, yelling or anything. So yeah. Alrighty guys, if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up. If you have any suggestions for music, movies, games alike, leave them in the comment section. I'll be sure to check them out. And to rate this album, probably give it a 5. Probably give it a 5 because I love Clementine Creevy. I love what she stands for. I've watched, you know, I'm a huge fan. I'm a huge fan of the band, and this album just had, you know, I think maybe. You know, two or three songs I haven't super gotten into, but other than that, the whole album was just bonkers, man. I was in love with it from the start. So yeah, peace.